This is the last book that I've read. It's a couple of years ago. Very inspiring book. I greatly enjoyed it. I think about it quite a bit. And I haven't read another book since. There's just so much to read on the internet, and I'm finding myself reading short articles all the time. And I think it's because you're able to make a comment, so I'm involved in comments in a lot of these articles. So I've been recently involved with Substack authors. And this one lady, she was talking about a book that she's recommending that she read, and a nice lady. And I kind of thought, oh, you know what, I should read a book. So I grabbed this one off the shelf. Look at this. The cost was $3 in 1902. This thing, I gotta keep my place, my finger in this place, because I'm gonna read you something. But here's how much it cost. That's the book. And here's the copyright date. I don't know why I grabbed it. I think I know why, actually. These sheets were in it. And there are tests that some lady took and was graded. These are graded tests from a long time ago. Beautiful cursive. But I'm reading along, and I'm not even finished with the book yet. I'm on page 160, and there's over 200 pages. And I got to read this to you because, in our minds right now is dominated this virus and this sickness, and it's just in our minds. And the law of mentalism talks about this. It has been demonstrated scientifically and conclusively that a perfectly well man can be made sick even unto death by being repeatedly told that he is sick. That's what we're being told right now, that we're sick. I will relate an experiment of this kind that has been fully authenticated. All the arrangements for the experiment were made without the victim having any knowledge of them. Mr. J, the person on whom the experiment was made, was a businessman. On a particular morning, he left his home for the office feeling that he was in excellent health. A few blocks from his house, he met an old friend who commented on how ill he was looking and asked if you were not sick. Mr. J only laughed at the suggestion. The idea of him being sick amused him. Before he had gone more than a block further, he met another old friend who seemed surprised at his appearance and seriously asked about his health. Stated that he had the appearance of one who was going to be quite sick. It reminds me of all this mainstream media news on TV. Go get that shot. These and similar statements were repeated to him by a number of other people before he reached his office. Each succeeding one, however, expressed more anxiety than the previous one. By the time Mr. J reached his office, he was not feeling quite so well. And as he left his house, for the thought had already taken root. Let me read that one over. He was not feeling quite so well as when he left his house, for the thought had already taken root. During the morning, a number of people dropped into his office and commented upon his apparent condition. Were they mean or what? By noon, he was a sick man, and before night, he was home and in bed. During the evening, some of the same people called to see him under the pretext of having heard of serious illness. They commented upon the seriousness of his condition, its dangers, and their fears for his recovery. Do you have COVID? If you think COVID 2 is bad, wait, COVID 3 is coming. Within 24 hours, this man who enjoying perfect health was brought to death's door by the mental and verbal dictates of his friends.
The purpose of the experiment was then revealed to him, but even with the assistance of the helpful thoughts of all those concerned, it took several days to eradicate the disease they had recreated and to replace it with good health. There is the lesson for you. Don't believe the pharma freak show. Their pills and injections don't work. It's right in there. All right. The law of mentalism. I got some other really good stories in here, too, I should talk about, but I just couldn't help myself. I had to get this one in before I finished the book.